Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. One of the most common questions that I get asked are, what are the differences between an admin on the platform and a developer on the platform? So let's talk about it. So where exactly would you draw the line between admin and developer? Let's talk a little bit about Salesforce as a company to help us understand the differences between these two things. Salesforce as a company is constantly trying to move responsibility from the developer and put this onto the admin. This is for a variety of different reasons that we will all go into. The first one being that administration is a lot easier to pick up than code. Different tools such as creating new objects, creating new fields, creating the different automations using the flows, it was a lot easier to understand than having to do that when learning code and doing that in a different language, essentially, and writing it down and making sure that the computer understands. And if you miss a freaking semicolon, then the whole thing's gone. I'm not salty, maybe just a little bit. But in general, administration is going to be a lot easier for someone on your team or someone at your company to just pick up rather than just picking up code. So that's reason number one. Reason number two is that if Salesforce is easier to use on all sides of it, then more people are gonna wanna use it. So if Salesforce is easier to create the different customizations on, and it's faster to be able to do that, then your users are gonna be happier and it's going to be a lot better of a process than if you have to develop all custom solutions and you can never do anything using administration. Number three is going to be the reasons. One of the most common reasons is that it's a lot easier to change any declarative changes than it is to change any code changes in the future. Declarative tools, meaning clicks instead of code, these are gonna be things like lead automation tools, case automation tools, process builders, which are being phased out, flows, and approval processes. This is a lot easier to change and a lot cheaper to change than it is to change code. Especially in my opinion, code needs to be changed every few years to update, as well as do flows and approval processes, but it's a lot easier to go into a flow and create a new element or a new system in there than it is to change a whole sheet of code. And number four is that it's a lot easier or it's a lot cheaper on the company to hire an admin than it is to hire a developer. Especially if you're a smaller, mid-sized company, or even if you're a larger company, it's a lot easier it's a lot cheaper to hire three admins than it is to hire three or four developers. Salesforce wants to make this the best experience possible for the companies that use Salesforce, the easiest, cheapest, and the fastest. So those are kind of a few of the reasons why Salesforce wants to move more towards declarative tools rather than developers. Now, it's not to say that developers are not useful. There's always going to be a need for developers for crazy one-off solutions that you can't use with a flow, or creating a lightning web component, or doing really complex automation. These are going to be things that you will need to do within Salesforce, but with more automation tools coming out with more features, those become farther and few in between. Before these automation tools, developers were in really high demand. Before we had any process builders, you wouldn't be able to create any new type of opportunity based upon an automation. It was either develop it or do this manually. Let's take for an example, my favorite example is the renewal opportunity. You are a company selling a product that needs to be renewed every year. This could be a subscription, this could be a product, what have you. Every year, you need to follow up with the company, see if they still want to work with you, have them re-sign another contract for the next year, maybe update the price a little bit, update how much they need. So you're able to create a new opportunity when the first one closes, so then you're able to follow up with them and not forget about it, have it fall through the cracks, what have you. So before the process builder, this had to be hard-coded into the system. So now you'd have to hard code any of the fields that you wanted to move over. You'd have to hard code any of the information that you wanted to move over, or do this completely manually. But now that we have process builders, and eventually we had flows, this is able to not be hard coded in, and anytime you want to make a change, you don't have to go in, hard code everything. And if you mess up one thing, it's not going to mess up the rest of the system. So that's a little rough explanation on why you'd want to use more declarative tools than code. So now let's get back to the real purpose of this video. Now that I've talked about a bunch of examples, where do you actually draw the line between admin and developer? This can be asked with usually just one simple question: can you do it with a flow? If you answer yes to that question, then it is going to be an administrative tool, an administrative thing typically. And if you can't do it with a flow, then unfortunately you have to go and have that automation be done by a developer. Now, of course, there are completely other aspects of the job than just automations and those kinds of tools. For an admin, it's going to be setting up users, it's going to be setting up objects, setting up fields, setting up all these different things, the security model especially. And for a developer, it's more than just automations as well. It's going to be different things like Lightning Web Components, and maybe you have some other visual aspects that you want to change about the Salesforce look and how it is. That is hopefully a good explanation for you to understand kind of what the differences are between an admin and a developer. Typically, it's going to be that all coding work is going to have to be done by a developer, and all administrative, all clicks are going to be done by an admin. Now, here's a little fuzzy part that I do want to bring up is when it comes to SQL. I do think that admins should have to know how to use SQL. This is because there's so much data that you need to work with as an admin, and if you want to go in and change maybe a few things or to visualize a data set in a certain way that you can't do within Salesforce, you should be able to do that as an admin and not have to rely on a developer to create the query for you. I also think that SQL is a fairly easy language to pick up, and you can honestly just pick it up by understanding the syntax as well as understanding how the reporting tools with filtering and sorting works. Because that's really all SQL is. It's filtering, grabbing different fields from different objects, and filtering and sorting. That's a simple explanation of SQL. But I hope that you found this helpful. Thank you so much for joining me. If you like this video, be sure to like, subscribe if you're feeling generous. Check out the courses down below. If you'd like to join the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.